Welcome to Snooze with Sam. My name is Sam, and I was raised high in the northwest of Scotland, on a little island called Skye. Ever since my late teens, I have struggled with sleep, the origins of which being a multitude of reasons. From then onwards, I've developed a passion for helping people connect with and better themselves in all areas of life, one area of which is helping others drift off into a peaceful sleep. I understand how the mind works, its complications, its tendencies, its habits, and how precious sleep can become as a result. These sleepcasts have been designed with this in mind. So lie back. Take a deep breath. And enjoy the story. This story is called At One with Nature by the Remote River Tummel. There is nothing quite like drawing lungfuls of the cleanest, crisp air, whilst surrounded by nature at its fullest. Pure isolation of the best kind. Somewhere in the geographical centre of Scotland. Around you are the densest coniferous trees, absorbing all light that enters, at least from where you're standing. Taking a few timid steps toward the tree line, you break the boundary from light to dark. Inside the woodland, the exposure and contrast changes as your eyes adjust to the gloom, and to your surprise, the world around you seems to change entirely from a dark, dingy abyss to a rich, green, and golden paradise with mosses, ferns, dropped needles, and space. The trunks of the trees leaving ample space between to wander in and around. Opening up your arms, you zigzag and slalom between the endlessly tall pines, gazing up into the canopy. Underneath your feet lies a cushion of vegetation so thick and cosseting, you make hardly a noise as you move. Just the soft clicks and cracks of small twigs and the rustle of pine needles. It is beautiful. The light source from above is broken, scattered and punctuated by the converging treetops. but occasionally one tree reaches tall enough to bask in the diffused glow of the sun, resultantly casting much of the golden light down to the forest floor below. The smell of this place is simply intoxicating. How can the air feel and taste so intense, yet so clean? The pine oil, the natural resins, wood, mulch, earth, foliage, moisture. All of these adding up to create some tantalizing cocktail of aromas and textures. It is almost oppressive. Yet, it is perfectly invigorating. It makes you ponder the fact that this beautifully scented, oxygen-charged air quality is maybe the real therapy we all truly need. Occasionally, you hear the squawks and screeches of buzzards, either perched in trees or circling above the canopy somewhere. It is hard to tell. Their presence is comforting. Even though you are seemingly alone, the reality is anything but. The company of nature's truest rightful occupants is a joyous thing to feel. You feel honored to be a guest among their lands. Aiming for a gap in the trees far ahead, you step carefully over the scatterings of forest debris, reluctant to disturb it. You feel as though a human footstep left behind almost spoils the untouched lie of the land. So tread carefully, you do. The nearer you get, you start to make out a picture beyond the trunks. You see moving water, rounded boulders, and a gentle haze. You draw closer and closer, feeling an almost supernatural pull into the light, like there is an energy willing you to return the open space, away from shelter. You break through, squinting as the brightness of the open sky overwhelms your retinas. As you readjust your sight, step forward across the threshold, woodland floor, to fist-sized pebbles, to larger boulders. Stepping up onto an enormous boulder, jutting out over the water, you walk towards the lip of the smooth, primer grey runway on the banks of the River Tummel. Gazing across the water to the opposite bank, you feel a wave of emotion overcome you, like the tide. A cool, persistent, moisture-rich breeze brushes your face, invigorating you as the water rushes past below you. Glancing upstream, you regard the scattering of dead trees, caught on rocks, having flowed downstream up until that point. They jut from the water like natural sculptures. This change of physical sensations may seem subtle, but their combination is moving. Perched in the open air, exposed and vulnerable, you feel alive. Holding your hands out, either side of you, you take a big, deep breath. You hold it for a moment, allowing your thoughts, feelings, and emotions to blossom. Reveling in the moment, willing to not let it go. You exhale as tears run down your cheeks. The breeze catches the moisture on your face, sending a cool chill through your body. Didn't realize how much it meant to you to be a part of your natural surroundings. in a world full of artificial thrills. We have forgotten how powerful our natural world can be, all on its own. You promise to embrace the world that we live in. Living your life with the deepest respect for all flora and fauna. You take a seat on the edge of the rock. Letting your feet dangle above the crisp, bubbling blue water below. Your view is all greens, greys, blues, and golden browns. You feel relaxed. There is nothing quite like drawing lungfuls of the cleanest, crisp air, whilst surrounded by nature at its fullest. Pure isolation of the best kind. Somewhere in the geographical centre of Scotland. Around you are the densest coniferous trees, absorbing all light that enters, at least from where you're standing. Taking a few timid steps toward the tree line, you break the boundary from light to dark. Inside the woodland, the exposure and contrast changes as your eyes adjust to the gloom, and to your surprise, the world around you seems to change entirely from a dark, dingy abyss to a rich, green and golden paradise of mosses, ferns, dropped needles, and space. The trunks of the trees leaving ample space between to wander in and around. Opening up your arms, you zigzag and slalom between the endlessly tall pines, gazing up into the canopy. Underneath your feet lies a cushion of vegetation so thick and cosseting, you make hardly a noise as you move. Just the soft clicks and cracks of small twigs and the rustle of pine needles. It is beautiful. The light source from above is broken, scattered and punctuated by the converging treetops. But occasionally, one tree reaches tall enough to bask in the diffused glow of the sun, resultantly casting much of the golden light down to the forest floor below. The smell of this place is simply intoxicating. How can the air feel and taste so intense, yet so clean? The pine oil, the natural resins, wood, mulch, earth, foliage, moisture. All of these adding up to create some tantalizing cocktail of aromas and textures. It is almost oppressive. Yet, it is perfectly invigorating. It makes you ponder the fact that this beautifully scented, oxygen-charged air quality is maybe the real therapy we all truly need. Occasionally, you hear the squawks and screeches of buzzards, either perched in trees or circling above the canopy somewhere. It is hard to tell. Their presence is comforting. Even though you are seemingly alone, the reality is anything but. The company of nature's truest rightful occupants is a joyous thing to feel. You feel honoured to be a guest among their lands. Aiming for a gap in the trees, far ahead, you step carefully over the scatterings of forest debris, reluctant to disturb it. You feel as though a human footstep left behind almost spoils the untouched lie of the land. So tread carefully, you do. The nearer you get, you start to make out a picture beyond the trunks. You see moving water, rounded boulders, and a gentle haze. You draw closer and closer, feeling an almost supernatural pull into the light, like there is an energy willing you to return to the open space, away from shelter. You break through, squinting as the brightness of the open sky overwhelms your retinas. As you readjust your sight, you step forward across the threshold, woodland floor, to fist-sized pebbles, to larger boulders. Stepping up onto an enormous boulder, jutting out over the water, you walk towards the lip of the smooth, primer grey runway on the banks of the River Tummel. Gazing across the water to the opposite bank, you feel a wave of emotion overcome you, like the tide. cool, persistent. Moisture-rich breeze brushes your face, invigorating you as the water rushes past below you. Glancing upstream, you regard the scattering of dead trees, cotton rocks, having flowed downstream up until that point. They jut in the water like natural sculptures. This change of physical sensations may seem subtle, but their combination is moving. Perched in the open air, exposed and vulnerable, you feel alive. Holding your hands out, either side of you, you take a big, deep breath. You hold it for a moment, allowing your thoughts, feelings, and emotions to blossom. Reveling in the moment, willing to not let it go. You exhale as tears run down your cheeks. The breeze catches the moisture on your face, sending a cool chill through your body. You didn't realize how much it meant to you to be a part of your natural surroundings. In a world full of artificial thrills, we have forgotten how powerful our natural world can be, all on its own. You promise to embrace the world that we live in, living your life with the deepest respect for all flora and fauna. You take a seat on the edge of the rock. Letting your feet dangle above the crisp, bubbling blue water below. Your view is all greens, greys, blues, and golden browns. You feel relaxed. You feel calm. You feel honored to be a guest. amongst these flowers.